Hi, I'm Leslie. I used the 5 videos to review the general thinking of the test makers in the HSK listening test and explained how to guess the conversation topic in advance to prove the accuracy of answer selection. The more advanced you take the HSK, the more you will appreciate how these tips can help you. In addition to helping you prepare for the HSK listening test, these conversational listening exercises are also a great way to improve your spoken Chinese. At my school, my colleagues and I also use these listening dialogues to give our students oral practice. I'm going to share our operation today, so you can try it yourself. I have always emphasized reading the answers before listening to the conversations. And that is just the way for the HSK listening test. When you practice speaking, you can't look at those choices at all. You must listen directly to the dialogues and then answer the dialogue's questions according to your understanding. This answer is entirely in your own words. There is a requirement that your response must be a complete sentence and cannot simply be given a single word, like HSK choices. This speaking exercise must be done after you have finished the listening exercise, because if you have already done the listening exercises, you will still have a little memory of what each conversation was about, which will help you with your speaking. This method of oral practice is of great help to two kinds of Mandarin learners. The first type of learners often lack a Chinese communication environment, such as those who have taught themselves Chinese or those who are not in China. Our listening topics are numerous, covering all aspects of daily life. Such learners will be able to get familiar with the daily communication of Chinese people through these exercises. The second type of learners are those who are not confident in their oral Chinese. I have met some learners whose accumulated vocabulary does not translate into fluent oral expression. In fact, the biggest problem is that they are too focused on reading textbooks. If every new vocabulary and grammar is learned by looking rather than listening or speaking, there will be a dilemma of trying to speak but not be able to. Learning a new language requires your eyes, ears, mouth, and brain to be exposed to the information of the new language at the same time, rather than hear but not speak, read but not hear, or speak but not hear. My colleagues and I design each course based on the principle of engaging students' brains, ears, eyes, and mouth to work together, as in this listening conversation series. If listening to a conversation trains your brain, eyes, and ears to work efficiently together, then the accompanying oral practice is to allow your mouth to express your brain thoughts smoothly. As I said in the previous video, our goal is to help students have free and confident practical communication in Chinese, and in turn achieve good HSK scores. So we hope that the listening materials we share here will serve multiple purposes and help you achieve the same goal. Okay, let's get started with today's listening exercise. After practicing your eyes and ears, don't forget to practice your mouth.
There are 10 conversations in this video. They will be played together 3 times. During each play, say each conversation only once. In the first play, you will see that each conversation has 3 answer options. Choose your answer according to what you hear. During the second play, you can check if you chose the correct answer. In the third play, there is an English translation of each conversation. Now for the first play.
我16岁，你多大？我应该叫你姐姐。
谁大？
二，你觉得这本书怎么样？
这本书很难，蓝色的那本好一点。
难的什么意思？
三，你换了新的手机吗？
没有，这是我朋友的手机，我的是苹果的。
手机是谁的？
四，师傅，车里太热了，开一下空调吧。
空调一直开着，不够冷吗？
空调怎么了？
五，你和张云海都会说西班牙语吗？
我只会一点，我经常问张云海西班牙语的问题。
谁的西班牙语好？
六，你买了什么包子？肉包子还是菜包子？
我只买了肉包子，我去食堂太晚了，菜包子没了。
男的想买什么包子？
七，你先吃点面包，我马上做饭。
好的，我帮你一起做饭。
你的为什么让男的吃面包？
八，这也是番茄吗？番茄不都是红色的吗？
小番茄有红色，也有黄色，你尝尝，也很好吃。
这种番茄什么颜色？
九，这只箱子太重了，我搬不动，你可以帮我吗？
我去看看手推车在哪里，等我一下。
他们怎么搬这只箱子？
十，你怎么不开车上班？你是坐地铁吗？
不是，骑自行车很方便，我家离公司也不远，走路也不累。
男的怎么上班？
It is going to do the second play. You can listen to each conversation again and confirm your answers. Please note that there is no pause between the second and third play. As soon as you have confirmed the 10th answer, the third play will begin. Then you will see an English translation of each conversation. All the right answers will be at the end. You can rate your answers.
我十六岁，你多大？
我应该叫你姐姐。
谁大？
二，你觉得这本书怎么样？
这本书很难，蓝色的那本好一点。
难的什么意思？
三，你换了新的手机吗？
没有，这是我朋友的手机，我的是苹果的。
手机是谁的？
四，师傅，车里太热了，开一下空调吧。
空调一直开着，不够冷吗？
空调怎么了？
五，你和张云海都会说西班牙语吗？
我只会一点，我经常问张云海西班牙语的问题。
谁的西班牙语好？
六，你买了什么包子？肉包子还是菜包子？
我只买了肉包子，我去食堂太晚了，菜包子没了。
男的想买什么包子？
七，你先吃点面包，我马上做饭。
好的，我帮你一起做饭。
你的为什么让男的吃面包？
八，这也是番茄吗？番茄不都是红色的吗？
小番茄有红色，也有黄色，你尝尝，也很好吃。
这种番茄什么颜色？
九，这只箱子太重了，我搬不动，你可以帮我吗？
我去看看手推车在哪里，等我一下。
他们怎么搬这只箱子？
十，你怎么不开车上班？你是坐地铁吗？
不是，骑自行车很方便，我家离公司也不远，走路也不累。
男的怎么上班？
一，我16岁，你多大？
我应该叫你姐姐。
谁大？
我16岁，你多大？
我应该叫你姐姐。
谁大？
二，你觉得这本书怎么样？
这本书很难，蓝色的那本好一点。
难的什么意思？
你觉得这本书怎么样？
这本书很难，蓝色的那本好一点。
难的什么意思？
三，你换了新的手机吗？
没有，这是我朋友的手机，我的是苹果的。
手机是谁的？
你换了新的手机吗？
没有，这是我朋友的手机，我的是苹果的。
手机是谁的？
四，师傅，车里太热了，开一下空调吧。
空调一直开着，不够冷吗？
空调怎么了？
师傅，车里太热了，开一下空调吧。
空调一直开着，不够冷吗？
空调怎么了？
五，你和张云海都会说西班牙语吗？
我只会一点，我经常问张云海西班牙语的问题。
谁的西班牙语好？
你和张云海都会说西班牙语吗？
我只会一点。我经常问张云海西班牙语的问题。
谁的西班牙语好？
六，你买了什么包子？肉包子还是菜包子？
我只买了肉包子。我去食堂太晚了，菜包子没了。
男的想买什么包子？
你买了什么包子？肉包子还是菜包子？
我只买了肉包子。我去食堂太晚了，菜包子没了。
男的想买什么包子？
七，你先吃点面包，我马上做饭。
好的，我帮你一起做饭。
你的为什么让男的吃面包？
你先吃点面包，我马上做饭。
好的，我帮你一起做饭。
你的为什么让男的吃面包？
八，这也是番茄吗？番茄不都是红色的吗？
小番茄有红色，也有黄色。你尝尝，也很好吃。
这种番茄什么颜色？
这也是番茄吗？番茄不都是红色的吗？
小番茄有红色，也有黄色。你尝尝，也很好吃。
这种番茄什么颜色？
九，这只箱子太重了，我搬不动，你可以帮我吗？
我去看看手推车在哪里，等我一下。
他们怎么搬这只箱子？
这只箱子太重了，我搬不动，你可以帮我吗？
我去看看手推车在哪里，等我一下。
他们怎么搬这只箱子？
十，你怎么不开车上班？你是坐地铁吗？
不是，骑自行车很方便，我家离公司也不远，走路也不累。
男的怎么上班？
你怎么不开车上班？你是坐地铁吗？
不是，骑自行车很方便，我家离公司也不远，走路也不累。
男的怎么上班？